as we're still loading a few more people to start introducing. Welcome to the European Union Film Festival Toronto, which started at the Goethe Institute 15 years ago and has now grown to 8,000 audiences with help of all European Union consulates and cultural institutes in Toronto and with you. My name is Jutta Brandemühl. I'm a board director of the EUFF and the program curator at the Goethe, bringing you this film tonight. November 9. November 9 is a sad and happy day in German and European history. We're thinking today of that horrific night of the 1938 November pogroms all across Germany and Austria that killed over 1,000 German Jews and sent 30,000 to concentration camps. And then 30 years ago, the Berlin Wall came down in a peaceful revolution where a whole people stood up to demand freedom, democracy, and civil rights. I personally might not be standing here tonight if my then very young mother and father hadn't grabbed two suitcases before the wall was built, literally running from East Berlin to West Berlin. 65 years late, I'm finally about to request access to my dad's and my aunt's Stasi files. And I know that some of you in the audience share these stories, and we want to tell this story tonight. I couldn't be more pleased to spend this evening with you in Toronto and present the premiere here of Ballon, based on the too crazy to be fictional, but it is a true story of two East German families fleeing to the West in a hot air balloon. You will recognize some of the actors, among them David Koss from The Reader, and Thomas Kretschmer, who has made a great Hollywood career for himself, so much so that I couldn't convince him to fly up to Toronto. His shooting would have been brilliant to have, of course. Here, interestingly, Kretschmer plays a Stasi colonel, and you might not even recognize him. But the actor and former competitive GDR swimmer Kretschmann, who was born in the East German Bauhaus city of Dessau in 1962. And in 1983, so quite a while before walking down and anybody saw, could have seen this coming, he began to study acting at the famous Gaspusch Academy in East Berlin, but weeks later decided to flee to West Germany via Hungary, Yugoslavia, then Yugoslavia and Austria, another European refugee story. If you're interested in more background, we have posted interviews with the real families who were consulting on the film, as well as the story how that other big German Hollywood star, director Roland Emmerich, you know, the guy who made Independence Day and others, helped make this film happen against the odds and against Disney. And we're featuring that on our German film at the end of the log. There's a few postcards outside if you want to grab those on your way out. On our 15th EUFF anniversary, a huge thank you to all of you, to all of our sponsors and partners for their generous and really loyal and ongoing support. Your contributions make this festival possible, and we're very grateful. And also, personally, very grateful to our friends at the German Consulate, who are, as always, standing here with us and in this room with us as I hand over the mic to my dear colleague, Laura Bruden. Have a good screening.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Laura Bruden, and I'm the cultural attaché of the German Consulate in Toronto. First of all, I'd like to thank you all for choosing such a great film for such an important anniversary. Because as Jutta said, today is a very special day for Germany. Exactly 30 years ago, on the 9th of November 1989, the Berlin Wall, which the protagonist of today's film tried to cross, was opened after almost 30 years of separation, and citizens of the former GDR where we finally have to travel freely towards Germany. As you all know, this marked the start of the German unification. And in my mind, this is the perfect fit that we celebrate this important anniversary among our European partners in the framework of the European Film Festival. Because German unification has also been a gift from Europe to Germany. Without the protests of citizens of East Germany, for example, Poland, and many other countries, and the general openness of our European partners to the idea of German unifications, this would have not been possible. And we can't thank our European partners enough for that. And I hope this also serves as a reminder that we can only tackle global challenges if we all work together and think beyond national borders. Now, I don't want to lose any more words and get back to today's film. If you enjoyed the film that you're about to see, please vote for it at the end of the film to become the EUFF Audience Choice Award movie. You can do this by submitting your markup to our volunteers upon leaving the theater. The winner of the Audience Choice Award will be announced after the film. And if you vote for this film, you will also have the possibility to win great prizes in the draw at the end of the festival. So please make sure to fill out your name and email address on the ticket. And at this point, you all like to give a big applause to all the volunteers of the festival. We will not be able to do this for 15 years. And finally, just some words for housekeeping. Please turn off all electronic devices.